Daktronics Show Control Software provides a complete control solution. A show control system includes Display Studio, Content Studio, and is associated with multiple types of digital media players such as the DMP7000, DMP8000, M3, etc. Display Studio is the primary user interface users interact with to run the digital signs. Content Studio is a creative composition and editing tool. The software allows users to design display-ready presentations with text, graphics, video, and real-time data. In this video, we'll take a look at what's new and any fixes that have taken place from April 29th to June 26th of 2020. You may have already noticed the logos have all been updated to reflect Daktronics branding. You are most likely familiar with the monitor wall in Display Studio. The monitor wall allows you to see what is playing on any of your supported displays without actually needing to see the physical display. New in version 2.22 is the multicast network technology that provides improved resolution and frame rate of the monitor wall. You can now also open the last workspace from a workstation. Each show control workstation will now open to the last workspace opened on that computer as opposed to the last open workspace on the server. And for those with workspaces with a lot of buttons, you're going to notice improved performance. A new feature available in version 2.22 of Show Control is the ability to give an alias to a file within any button type. Designed to be used in conjunction with the Mark In, Mark Out feature released with version 2.21, this will allow users to take one large clip that may have been multiple ads or highlights within it and break it down with the ability to give a different alias for those breakdowns to be seen within the queue. For example, you could load one large recorded clip and then use the Mark In Out feature to set the first 10 seconds to be highlight number 1, then the next 10 seconds are highlight number 2, etc. Then the user can give an alias name to each of those new clips within a playlist or play button. The alias name will also show in the queue within a quick display container and in the status log within a scripting container. Now we'll look at some updates to Content Studio. Version 2.22 updated the DID and DSRC files in the installer, and this means that you'll see updated RTD fields in the data library. Version 2.21 added a font styles feature. This feature helps you when you run across data that doesn't fit into the field. If it's not fitting with the primary font style, you can then switch over to the alternative font style, which may be a smaller size font or non-bold fonts that may fit into the field better. This can also be used in conjunction with the existing shrink to fit property on a field. What does that mean for you? If the data doesn't fit with the primary font, the DMP will try the alternative font style if you have that specified, but if that doesn't yet fit and you have the shrink to fit enabled, we will then use that method with the alternative font style to make the text fit the field. A great side effect of this feature is this tool allows content creators to configure custom font styles. This includes font, size, paragraph, settings, etc. Create styles that align with your branding to add consistency and speed to your message creation. Knowledge Base article, How Do I Create and Use Alternative Font Styles in Content Studio? Will walk you through the steps of using this great new feature. You can find our knowledge base at www.daktronics.com/support. Fixes. Updates also provided fixes for features that aren't working as intended or improvements to the operation of the software. Display Studio fixes in version 2.22 fixed an issue with multi-line Camino timeline script alters both lines. Version 2.21, Display Studio installer hangs on SQA Venus. Right-click paste puts button where the paste option is selected instead of where original click was. Unable to select quick display button setup steps after selecting the set color or set thumbnail option. Content Studio fixes. Version 2.22. Right-click in storyboard for cut copy selection. Copy paste script buttons get changed from continuous from number of times. Preserving index with changing data from home to guest team bio. Multi-field dialog working with multiple path nodes. Extra color palettes being created for highlight data effect. Setting highlight font color for individual data fields. scrolling text causing a crash in the editor, unpausing the file preview issues. Version 2.21 fixed saving the V7000 content, fixed paging adding slides instead of pages, fixed ESR 2435 Content Studio only shows the output dimensions and not the sign dimensions for players without a layout file, and fixed checkerboard canvas background not working. Interested in updating? Please note, updates and improvements are often impacted by the type of system your show control interfaces with. Learn more by contacting our professional services team at www.dactronics.com/professional-services. Use the following resources for more information or assistance. You can find the My Support resource at www.dactronics.com/my-support. Use the My Support portal to create a new service case, view open service cases, check order and shipping status, verify account information. You can even select email text settings to receive case notifications. For more information on show control software, search our online knowledge base at www.dactronics.com/support using keywords show control along with the topic you are interested in. To speak with a technician or customer service in the United States and Canada, call 1-800-DACTRONICS. Outside the U.S. and Canada, dial country code +1, then 605-697-4000.